Testing shoulder abduction against gravity position. Patient will be seated, shoulder comfortably by the side, palm facing forward. For first thing you will have your patient do is perform full shoulder abduction. Go ahead and do that for me, Rach. Come back down. Because she's able to do that, we know that it is at least a grade 3. To test for four grades 4 and 5, I will test for 2 separate muscles, the supraspinatus and the middle deltoid. To do the supraspinatus, I will first have Rachel perform 20 degrees of abduction. So go ahead and go about 20 degrees. I will stabilize the scapula and push down on the humerus here. Resist me, Rachel. 3, 2, 1. To test for the middle deltoid, I will have her go into 90 degrees of abduction. Once again, stabilize the scapula, push down on the humerus.
Resist me. 3, 2, 1. Come back down.
Depending on her resistance, I will grade her as a 4 or a 5 for those individual muscles. Testing shoulder abduction, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be supine, arm comfortably at the side, palm facing upward. When she performs abduction, if you notice, she's sliding across the table here, but if you do not have a table, or if her shoulder is hanging off the table, you can support her with your own hands, but just make sure that you're supporting her and not assisting her into abduction. So when testing abduction, I will be once again testing for 2 muscles, the supraspinatus and the middle deltoid. I will have my patient perform 20 degrees of abduction first. So go ahead and do that for me, Rachel. Because she's able to, and now bring it back in. Because she's able to do that, I will grade her as a 2 for the supraspinatus. Now, Rachel, I want you to go out 90 degrees of abduction. Good, bring it back. Because she's able to do that, I would grade her as a 2 for the middle deltoid. If she could not have any range of motion, then I would palpate the middle deltoid located here. If I feel this muscle firing, that is a grade 1. If I do not feel it firing, that is a grade 0.